Hi everybody, Will Alexander from Will Alexander's Dog Show Tips, brought to you by Canine Chronicle TV. I just want to let you know that today I spent the afternoon, a wonderful afternoon, with Ramon Podesta, one of my very favorites. Haven't seen Ramon in ages. It was great to catch up. I hope you guys enjoy the conversation. Hi, everybody. We're here today with Mr. Ramon Podesta. He doesn't need much introduction. The whole world knows Ramon. How are you, Ramon?
Everything okay. Very happy to be in your program.
Well, thank you for allowing us to interview.
Many thanks for having me here. Many thanks.
Good. Well, it's good to see you. It's great to catch up. I'm going to get right into it, Ramon. Tell us how you got involved in the sport of dogs and how old you were when you started.
Yeah, well, I always liked the dog since I have I always have liked dogs, but I was very lucky to have in my neighborhood a lady who was a boxer breeder. She lived three homes from my home. So every day I go in the afternoon to see his dog, and he take out her home, the dog, for walking. And at the beginning, I start helping her to walk the dog. And I was 7 years, and she decided to go to the dog show. And she asked my father if I can go with her and help her. She knew I loved the dog. So at 7 years, we went to our first dog show with her. Since that time, since I was seven, never I stopped to go into the dog show in Santiago City. So I started very, very young going to dog show. And at the beginning, of course, I helped her, but she tried to teach me. And at the show, I knew another people. So when I was 12 years, I finished the first champion made for her, and I helped to hand the dog.
Oh, good.
So I was very proud and very happy. But in the meantime,
you caught the bug at 7 years old, basically.
Yeah. So
sorry, go ahead.
But my the breed I loved was German Shepherd. Mm-hmm. So every Christmas. Every Christmas, I asked to my father, I want the German Shepherd, but I went with pedigree, of course. So when I was 12, my father came from Christmas Day with the German Shepherd female with a very good pedigree. So that dream came true, and was so happy, and I started going to the dog show with her, till that time, when I was 12, 13 years old, I was very involved with the Kennel Club of Chile, because they have his office in Santiago, and I helped them in the dog show to set the ring, to be a steward with the judge, to clean, to do everything I could do, I did for my club. And was, for me, a very good manner to be close to the people who knew at that time, the judges, the people who were breeders. And so since that time, I started very close working for my club. So when I was 17, I became to be a member of the board of my club. And I was member of the board in the Pekingese Club too, and I helped a lot. I became to be president of the Pekingese Club when I was 18, 19 years old.
That's a young president.
And work a lot in all the aspects, like to prepare the show, to at that time we have more facility in some way than now. So our show, for by example, for the Pekingese Club in Chile, were done in the best hotels, accommodation. We have a pasarela, we have a tea, and the people was more a social thing, and of course, with good dog and good judge. So was there were very good time. So my life started from that way. And when I was 17, I met, well, at that time, at 17, I had already 8 or 7, 8 German Shepherd, and I was already just, I was breeding, and I was doing very well with the breed.
It's a lot of work for a German 17-year-old.
Yeah, but I had to school, I had to study, but all the time was in my book, I was drawing German Shepherd, I was drawing the dog, I like it. So I spent, well, I went to the class, but I was not thinking in the class, I was thinking in my dogs all the time. So I had to study, because the only thing that my father asked me is I want to have dogs, because at that time I have 15 dogs at my home.
Wow.
The only thing I have to do is it has to study. Only thing he asked me is to study. So I was 19 when I went to the university to study veterinarian, but always my head was in the dog. So I studied for 3 years. I came to the third grade, and I spoke with my mother, and my father said, I don't want to study. I want to have my kennel. I want to have my, I want to do what I like. But in the meantime, already when I was 17, I met my good friend, who's Netala, and we founded the Houseman Kennel when I was 17. So at that time, I was breeding.
You were just breeding German Shepherds at that point, though, right?
I had German Shepherd all my life. I stopped having the German Shepherd.
Yeah, you still have German
Shepherd. I still have. But I had another breed. We have some Borzoi, we have Dalmatian, we have Beagles, and Basset Hound at that time. So we had a lot of fun. And in the 80s, at the beginning in the 17, at the when I were 21, 22 years, we did very well with the Borzoi, and we did a lot of winning, many Vesti Show, many Dog of the Year, and a dog breed by myself. So we started very well in the breed. And since that, I never stopped breathing. I have been crazy all my life. And I like all breed. I like, of course, I like the Borzoi, the Afghan.
When did the Afghan,
standard poodle.
When did the Afghans come?
The Afghan came exactly when I was 17 years old. I saw the first Afghan in Chile. Was shown by the famous judge now, who is not with us, but was a Wilacos kennel from Mr. Norman Guidobro. And he chose an Afghan. Mm-hmm. So I decided I want to have an Afghan, but the breeder don't want to sell to another person. So finally we talked to her, and we got a very nice female. And since that, I have Afghan all my life. So.
Okay, so you started breeding Afghans even back then.
Yes, all the time. But I breed with that line for maybe 7, 8 years. And then I met, in one of my trips to Argentina, I went to my friend home, Adriano Bosa, who is an international of breed judge, and he has a little Afghan. And he offered me to give me one of the puppies. So I went to pick one of the puppies. And that the breeding was a lot more than what I wanted to have. They were more elastic, have a better movement. They have more, they look, the eyes, they look through you. They were really, really nice Afghan. So I forget the line I have because the dog I have at that time who bought from Norman, another person, there were dogs who, if you look the pedigree, the pedigree was full of champion, all red. But they were mismatched, how you say, you have mixed, he only look about pedigree, and he don't look about conformation, about a real one okay, type.
So that was a mixed up pedigree.
So, yes, but all red. And for many people who are starting, they say, they think a red pedigree, full red, is something fantastic. But it's not one line. So I didn't use more that breeding, and I start with this the new dogs. And since that, I have been very successful, very successful.
Beautiful dogs. Yes.
For many generations. And now, from that breeding, to go back to that first dog I bought from Argentina, I make a line, and now it's 16 generation. All the dogs go from to my initial breeding from the dog I import from Argentina. Wow. All of them. No, so, and I think I have been lucky, I have been improving all the time.
You have beautiful Afghan hounds.
And I have some very nice, and I have some young dog that I trust in them, and I think they have a bright future. I am very excited. I want to go to the dog show soon. I want the people to see them. They are really outstanding quality, in my opinion. So very happy about that.
When did you start judging, Ramon?
Oh, I started judging in 1978.
How old were you?
1927.
Wow, that's a young judge.
Yes, very young, but I lived in...
But you've been in it all. You've been in dogs since you were seven. So.
I had been at that time for 10 years in the board of the club, as director or president of club. So I have been really very involved, a great involvement in the sport. So, and in the meantime, I bred another dogs, of course, not only the Afghan, not only the Shepherd. With the Shepherd, I was very successful for many years. I got the number one dog all breed in the country with German Shepherd, maybe for 18 years. Many best in show. And we won the Latin American Championship at that time, who was like our world dog show for all the Latin American country. And with dogs who was breeder, owner, and handler, and competing with the top people from many, at that show, people bring some handler from Germany. So it was a very tough competition, and I won 3 or 4 times that show with the dog was named Rashid von Haumann. His sister, Rhoda von Haumann. So I was really not an old person. I was 33, 34. And there was in the book of the German Shepherd in America, Mrs. Anna Caterina Nicholas, the published interview and a visit to my kennel and a lot of pictures from most of my dog. So I was very popular being not
too old. Still popular.
So I did very well with the German Shepherd. But I did well with another breed, like Irish Setter. I have a top of breed again with the Irish Setter for
maybe. I didn't know that. I didn't know you had an Irish Setter. That's news to me.
Wow. Yes, I have some nice dog for nice breeding from coming from Mr. Eldridge Tirbelda, and later I used some very nice dog who I got from Tom Grafford, and then I have I use a dog from Meadowlark, but after that I have some health problem, so I don't want to have more health problems, so I stopped the breeding with the Irish Setter.
Oh, that's a shame. But that's my breed. So I'm surprised. I didn't know you bred them, but that you said some major names there. Mr. Eldridge, I had known when I first met Mr. Eldridge, I was about 12. So
yeah. So I love Irish Setter. I really love the breed. It's a wonderful breed. I would like to see more. I just said that again.
Yeah. You judged so many dogs over the years. Do you have dogs in your head that have just left a stamp on you that you can't forget?
Oh, yes, many.
Yeah.
I have been lucky to see many good dogs, but maybe one of the dog more attractive for me was when I judged the world show in Finland, mm-hmm. and I did a group 9. Was an honor to do that show, and I gave the group to a papillon who came from America to that show with Mr. The handler was John Ulton,
oh yes,
an English. And the dog went best in show. And you see the dog and your heart beat like crazy and really very excited. So, but I had the opportunity to judge many big shows. And by example, when I gave best in show at Buck County, Tim Bracer with the beautiful white standard poodle. So, dog, you never will forget. Or when I give to Peter Green and the Terrier Galsul, excellent. Oh. He was my best in show. So I have been lucky to travel around the world and see different dogs and appreciate the quality, and always will learn to see and to be involved with good dogs. Mm-hmm. I also want to tell you, I have been involved for many years with poodles.
Standard poodles?
Standard poodle. I have a standard. I have miniature.
Okay.
Standard and miniature. And at that time, I have very nice miniature poodle. But also, I stopped the breeding because some health problem. I was breeding with the Montfleury bloodline, and they were absolutely beautiful, beautiful coat, everything. But they have problem with the eyes, and so after many years, I stopped breeding the poodle. I have a dog also. I bought a dog from Mrs. Clark, a miniature black poodle. His name was Surrey Sugar Cane. We finished in America the dog. Very easy, very fast. And he produced some nice dogs, some best in show winner here for us. And I have also a couple of miniature I bought from Rita Holloway. Waver dog, a son of Waver Riptide, who was a very nice dog too. So, but also I had a standard bull there. And I learned a lot of dog and of breeding from Wendell Sammet. My best friend in America was D. Shepherd.
Oh, really?
We were like brothers. He came at least 3 or 4 times to Chile. He stayed for a week with us for vacation. I went to America, and I went to the dog show with them, with Wendell and Dee, and we went to PCA many times. We went to the Maltese, the Shih Tzu specialty, and was a really a very good way to learn more about.
That'd be an education with those two for sure. Oh my gosh.
Yes, and talking to Wendell about breeding, about construction, about the essence of the breed, for me was a great experience, and always I am grateful of him, and so happy, so grateful to the life who gave me the opportunity to meet great people like him.
That's an education for sure. Wendell's an icon in our sport. So was Dee. Dee was fabulous. I still remember watching Dee when he won the group of the guard with the black bitch. That was amazing.
Well, with Alikai 80.
Yes.
Dee was so talented. Was so artistic. Was and he had the eyes. He had the ability. He was a great hunter for me. We spent a lot of time and we learned from each other.
I met Aries. So, I was working with Allison, and I were working for Linda Campbell at the time from Darwin Poodles, and Aries came up to be bred to one of her dogs. So it was fun to see her, and she was amazing. Even cut down, she was amazing. It was a lot of fun.
These
dogs so, that passed by our door.
Yeah, so we have, and we did well with the standard poodle here in Chile. I have some dogs, of course, from Wendell, and I have some dog from Carlos Renault in Spain, and I have another female I brought from Tina Palosari, from Tina in Finland. So we have I think at that time the best bloodline from the world.
That's amazing, Ramon, because like
3 years ago.
Sorry. I just find it amazing
3 years ago,
that you bred so many different breeds at such a high level. It's so hard for some people to breed one breed at a high level, and you've bred all these different breeds at high levels. It's amazing.
Yeah. I was lucky to know how to choose the best producer and to see which are the good line. And with the standard poodle, 3 years ago, one of our breeding was number one old dog in the country. So, or breed. So, still I have some standard poodle, but it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. So, but I love the breed. I really love the breed. They are fantastic.
Yes.
So, and I of course, being with Dee and with Wendell, with Dee, we bred some Shih Tzu, but we sent to another people, and I did a lot of winning with the Maltese. For at least 10 years, we have the top dog in the country with Maltese of my breeding. So parallel to the Afghan and the other, I have been involved in different breed and with a lot of success. So I have been lucky.
You've been lucky. You keep saying you've been lucky. It can't all be luck, Ramon. Very modest. I've been lucky.
So,
you've been lucky. You get lucky with one dog. You don't get lucky with like 5 and 6 different breeds. There's got to be a method to your madness.
I enjoy very much the breeding. Always I am I'm dreaming what will be my next generation. How I would like, what I would like to improve. all the time we had to try to fix something. So, but sometimes the dreams come true, but you had to try very hard.
Well, I'm sure. What advice would you give breeders, Ramon?
I think first you have to know what you want to breed, what is your goal, your dogs, what you want to improve, what are the virtues, of course, and what are the problems you want to solve. And don't think if you have a dog big and a female small, you have a medium size if you breed them together. You have to have in your head what is the type of dog, what is the thing you have to improve, to have the balance, to have the quality, which is the essential of the breed. And then try to find the right dog. And never think if you are a breeder, you are going to make a lot of money. That is not true. We never do money, never. Always we lose money. But but you win something who cannot buy with the money. You got the to be honored, you to be proud, to be so happy when you have something who is really represent what you think, what you are breeding.
Wow. And you've been judging for my God, how many years? You said 78. So you've been judging for 40 plus years. What about advice? Yes. What about advice to judges?
First, I think, again, you have to be honest. You have to do and try to learn and not go in the middle of the ring since you have good eyes only. You have to know the standard. You have to study the standard. Try to know which is the sense of the breed, which is the quality. Judge only for more for quality than for fault. But you don't see how to tell you. I have problem even here in my country when you have people who want to be judged and never have been bred a best in show. Never even a group winner from one breed if they want to be all breed judged and they don't have the experience. And then they play the game, they know this is the president, this is the secretary, I have to place this, and that is very bad for our sport. Yeah. You have to try to do your best, to be honest, and to award to the best dog. Even if you have a different idea, but you have to give your honest opinion. No play the game. That's yeah. My advice. Maybe yeah. I am so rigid, but I hate when I see judge, when you are inside, we are inside, I see a judge who doesn't know how to approach to the dog. You know, immediately he don't have any idea how to go over the dog. And what are you checking? And so I think I have big mouth. I get furious when I saw that. So, but that's my way of thinking.
Well, it's funny. So, out of all these breeds you've had, can you pinpoint one as a favorite or probably not? Is it still German Shepherds?
I like German Shepherd especially because his brain, his temperament still are part important in my heart. But I can tell you now I am involved with the new project because I have Shiba Inu for many years, maybe 25, 30 years. I have had Shiba Inu. I got my first Shiba from Mr. Toyosako Kariyabu, who was the president of the Japanese Kennel Club at that time, and he gave me the first couple of Shiba. But Shiba at that time they were very reserved. They were not so so happy to go in the show. So, but still keep my line. And then in the last year, I come back with them again, and I import some dog from Japan, and I got the present from, really, I have been very lucky because I got a present from my friend from Mexico, Mr. Masanori Fujimoto, who's an old breed judge, and he's Japanese, and he traveled a lot to Japan. And I got a very nice quality dog, very nice, and I got a female. And then I traveled to, I was judging in Japan, and I met another Chiba breeder, Mr. Yoshi Murayama, and he gave me another absolutely beautiful, beautiful young male. So he's with me now. And I am really with all my heart, and I want to succeed and to produce and to breed a nice quality. So that is my goal now. But still I have my Afghan, of course. So
how many breeds have you bred over the years? Can you?
Oh, I don't know how many, but many breed really since maybe the I breed Japanese Chin. Yes, I have whipped.
I think the first time I met you was through Max Magder, I think.
Ah, yes, Max was a great friend of mine.
Yes.
A person I love it. And a real good dog, man.
Yes.
And I learned a lot from Max.
Me too.
We have some nice meetings, some nice talking. I went to his home and spent some days, and he came to my home two or three times, and we have wonderful time together. A couple of times he traveled with Franz Abela, and he spent 7-8 days with us, and was a great learning experience from Franz Abela and him. We were all the day looking dog, talking dog, thinking a dog, and learning a lot. For me, it was wonderful. I miss him. I miss Max a lot. So
yeah, we all do here as well.
Make you to grow, to learn, to be more respectful, to understand more the breed. I am very grateful for that. So
how fun would it be to go to evaluate dogs with you, Max, and Frank? Oh my God, that'd be amazing.
Yes, when they were here, they came to in the morning. We had breakfast and then go to the kennel, see 3-4 dogs moving. Frank teach me how to move, which is the speed, how to stack, many tips. And I have photos when we were sitting on the track, in my track, in the behind, and Frank don't like it, the dog running in the bicycle. We ran the dog from the track in the sitting in behind. And was Frank and me and my hand, and the dog was coming with us trotting. So, but it was a lot of fun, a lot of learning experience. It was fantastic.
Oh my gosh, I can't imagine.
So very grateful of the life I have with meeting these people.
Oh, for sure. That's amazing. Over the years, do you have any favorite wins that you talked about the world show and the Latina show? Is that your favorite win over the years? Those ones?
I see to win with the German Shepherd was my favorite, my big emotion. Of course, I have won the Las Américas y el Caribe Championship many times in South America, who is our biggest show. But to win with that German Shepherd was something I never will forget.
Yeah.
And I remember, and my eyes get wet, and it's a feeling I cannot explain.
That's amazing, Ramon. That can still bring those kind of feelings out on you after everything you've done, you know. So it's
yes, but also when my dog, the German Shepherd, name was Rashid von Hausmann, the German Shepherd, and I never used that name before, and when I have maybe in the 2009, I have a litter, Afghan litter, and I gave the name Rashid to one of the puppies. And this dog went to UK, and when there was the world show in Denmark, this dog was a world champion. And so I was so happy to give that name to Rashid again, to a great dog. So I knew he was something special. And that show in Denmark was really good because in the breed, the world champion male and world champion female were my breeding. And my female, who was best of breed, Nasira, Al Nasira, bin Rula von Haumann, she was a group winner, and she was best in show number 3 in the world show. So also was a big compliment and recognition for my breeding.
That's amazing, Ramon. So if you come out with another Rashid, we better look out, right?
Yes. So,
do you have any superstitions about dogs or dog shows that we don't know about?
No.
No, nothing.
No.
Listen to him. No. Although Rashid was a lucky name that you named. I don't know.
So
okay. So what's next? You're gonna keep on breeding for that next great one, and you're gonna keep on judging once the dog shows start up again. Have you had dog shows there? Have you been having dog shows?
No. We don't have nothing. No shows till the end of the year, maybe we are going to have something. But I will go to some shows in America if we can send some dogs and to show them.
Yeah, because there's still a lot of shows there. So we have no shows up here.
So yeah, but it depends how is the situation. Because here we start having the now is one today 1 million of people is already got vaccination in our country, which is a good number because the total population may be 17 million. So it's not too bad.
Yeah, that's a good percentage. And, good.
And they are improving every day. So I hope the president say maybe in 2-3 months we have all the population with vaccination. That would be good. Yes. That would be good.
Yes. Have you been vaccinated yet?
No, it's not my turn yet. They turn by different age. Okay. So next Monday I have the day to be vaccinated.
Okay.
So my English is not very good, but I'm sorry.
I understand you.
I hope that your people can understand me, and I ask to forgive me my bad pronunciation.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. We understand you. And I can see it in your eyes too, what you're trying to say. Anyway, if you could meet the 20-year-old Ramon now, is there any advice you'd give him?
I would tell you, don't worry. The dreams come true. Do what you want. Do what you like. If you like something, you can do well. But always have to be sincere and honest and to do what really you like, and let's do with all the effort, with all the passion, and you will be lucky, get to succeed at the end of the day.
Well, that's good advice. And it sounds like you've done all those things. So, well, I want to thank you for your time, Ron. I appreciate you giving us to us, and I know you're busy there with your kennel and your reading program. And I hope to see you sometime soon. I haven't seen you for at least a couple of years now. So,
yes. But I hope to see you soon, and all the best for you, for all your public. And it has been great to be talking with you.
Well,
thank you very much for having me.
It's great to see you. And take care. We'll talk to you soon, I hope.
Bye-bye.
Bye, Ruben.
An amazing man, that guy. He can do everything. Well, if you like what we're doing here, make sure you press the like, share, and subscribe button. If you want to get a hold of me, you can get a hold of me at dogshowtips@gmail.com. Or if you just want to find out what's happening at Will's World, just go to willalexander.net. All right. See you next time. Stay safe out there.